Hello friends, welcome to Selenium WebDriver training session 34. This is Haradhan once again as usual. In this session, I will discuss what is by all locator and how we can use the same locator in Selenium WebDriver. Thank you all for watching my videos. In case you are enjoying my videos and learning automation testing and Java, please like and share my videos. Do not forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get notification as and when I will upload any new videos. Do not forget to provide your valuable comment for an input or suggestion. Stay tuned for my next videos. So you already know, right? There are 8 different element locator available in Selenium WebDriver through which we can identify an web element available in the web page. And we can perform the any operation, right? If it is the edit box, we can add some value, enter some value in the edit box. If it is checkbox, we can tick the checkbox. If it is a radio button, we can select the radio button. If it's an image or link, we can click on the image or link, right? If it's a button, we can hit the enter kind of stuff on the button, like that. And there are 8 different element locator available, like ID, name, class name, tag name, link text, partial link text. And in case this through which like we are not able to identify the element, then we can create our own XPath and CSS selector. So these are the 8 different element locator available. Okay. And with any element locator, if we are able to identify the element, we can definitely identify the element. And after identification is done, we can perform the operation, right? So for ID, name, okay, link text, partial link text, only one option is possible. We can provide the ID. Okay, but whenever we are creating XPath or CSS selector, right, we can give two alternate attributes. Like we can give ID, we can give name. Suppose we will give the condition that name this or ID this. But it is not possible to enter more than two attributes whenever we are creating our own XPath or CSS selector, right? So what happened in case whatever two attributes we have given, they changes, right? So obviously our script will fail because the script will not able to identify the object or element, right? So our script will fail. So to avoid this thing, there is another option, so locator available in Selenium WebDriver, which is named as by all. Okay, so by all is an extra special locator in Selenium WebDriver which helps user to find the element based on the given locators. Locator could be any type, like ID, name, class name, link text, partial link text, XPath, CSS, okay, or maybe tag name. So by all locator tries to find the element using the first locator. If element is not present, then it wait for given implicit wait time. Once it reaches the maximum wait time and there is no element, then by all method tries to find the element using the second locator and third and fourth, like that, until it either it finds the element or there is no more locators left to validate. Okay, suppose in case you are giving 2-4 locator, okay, and if it is finding with the help of first locator, obviously it will perform this operation, right? And in case first locator is not able to find, so it will wait for the timeout, implicit timeout, whatever you have given, 10 seconds, 20 seconds. After that timeout elapsed, after that it will went to the next locator, and even it is failed, so again wait for the implicit timeout whatever you given, again wait for the third locator, and even if third locator also not working fine, so it will go for the last locator. In case this last locator working fine, it will perform the operation, otherwise it will show that like element not found. So that is the major advantage using the by all locator. So you can give multiple locator whatever available. In case any locator is matching, so it will still perform the operation for the particular element, right, or object available in the web page, right? So syntax, you can see the syntax: divert.findElement, not find elements, find element only. You need to use new keyword by all method, then by dot class name, you can provide class name, by.id element ID, by.name element name, and also you can give XPath CSS like that, comma separated by comma. After that, you need to close that particular syntax and you need to send keys or maybe click or maybe whatever this operation is that done, you can do it, right? Once the object identification is done, okay? So I will show you the real-time example. Suppose a Facebook page is there, right? If I open the Facebook page, there's a field called email or a phone, right? If I want to add some value in the email field, okay? So first you need to inspect the element. You need to press F12 button from your keyboard, right? Then you need to mouse over the inspect element to the field, okay? So you can see the element properties is coming, right? So let's first try to identify the elements through class, okay? So here I already created a class by all locator. I am setting the properties for the Chrome driver. I am launching the Chrome driver, maximizing it. I am passing the URL for Facebook and waiting for 20 seconds. Then after that, I want to find the element through the class attribute, okay, or class element locator technique by dot class name, okay, and here I am giving the class name and text. Then as it is a text field, I can provide some input. Suppose Haradhan. Okay, let's run the code and let's see what is happening. Obviously, it will try to identify the element by class name. In case it is able to find out, right, it will perform the operation, it will enter the value, or it will fail the test case, notifying that no such element found. So after launching the Chrome browser, it is trying to pass the URL for Facebook. Once the page fully loaded, you can see, right, through the class name, it is able to find the element, right, and it is entering the value as Haradhan here, okay. Now, do one thing. Suppose the class name has been changed, instead of input text, it has been changed to input text 1, okay. Okay, input text 1. So obviously, it will not, right. So here I have given suppose input text 1, but the class name got changed to suppose input text. Okay, so it should not match actually. Whatever you have selected, actually real time it's not matching. Okay, so what will happen? So here I have given input text 1, here originally is input text. So it will not match, right? So it will throw some error. Okay, let's see. It is throwing some error or not. Because the object will not be identifiable, right? Whatever element locator you have given or element locator value you have given, right? So class name, we have given that 1, but it was not matching. Obviously, it should be failed and your value will not be entered here, right? And your script will fail. Okay, it is not entering that particular word, Haradhan, right? And here, if you go to the console, you can see, right? Cannot locate an element using class name. Input text 1, right? Obviously, it was input text only. We have given input text 1. So, it will not be matching and test case is failing, right? But here, it is not possible to give multiple properties at the same time, right? Because only we can give one unique property, either class name or link text, partial link text, CSS or expert like that, okay? So, that is the reason there is some problem, right? In case that particular attribute is getting changed, it is not matching, it can fail the test case. To handle this thing, there is another option called available, right, by all method, right, it's available. So here, how to write the syntax, same thing, diver dot find element, new keyword, by all, bracket, by dot id name or class, right, you can give, okay, suppose by class name, I am giving the class name exactly, input text, okay. Okay, then after that I am giving some comma, then again I am giving another properties, by dot id. What is the id? Id is id and name is email, right? I can keep it by dot id. By dot id. The ID name. Okay. By dot. Similarly. Okay, one second, it will not be within the bracket. After that, we need to give by dot id. Okay, not by id, by dot id, and we need to give the id. And again, comma, we need to give by dot name, okay, not by name, it will be name only. We need to give the name, right? And there is a, we need to close all the packet. So one bracket I have closed, two bracket I have closed, another bracket I have to give. After that, dot send keys. Dot working at all by all one bracket, two bracket, and three bracket dot send keys. Not working. We need to import it. Okay, first we need to import the by all methods, right? From the org.openq.selenium.support.pagefactory. Otherwise, it will not be allowed. Or it will throw some error. Okay, then dot send keys. You can see after that is coming. Okay, suppose here if you want to give the name, okay, suppose Haradhan Pal, I want to give it. Okay, now you can see there is no such error. Okay, so what happens? So I have given three properties which are correct, right? Input text, email, and name, three are correct. So it will try to validate first with the class name. In case it is matching, it will immediately enter the send keys. In case it is not matching, it will wait for 20 seconds. Whatever implicit timeout is given, it will go for the next condition. Again, it is matching, it will immediately perform the operation. In case it is not matching, it will wait for 20 seconds another time and it will go for the third condition, right? Okay, in case third condition is matching, it will perform the operations or it will display the error message. So that is the important thing, right? So instead of, in case multiple attribute got changed, and here using the by all method, we can provide multiple attribute, whatever possible. We can add also a CSS XPath like that. So if any of the attributes get matched, right, it will take some time because for each and every like locator technique, it will wait for the, I mean, time, implicit timeout, whatever you have given, but it's, the script will never fail, right? Okay, let's run. So all the three is correct. So obviously immediately it will be like and enter the value in the name field, okay, sorry, in the email field. Okay, in case first attribute, so element is not matching, locator is not matching, it will wait for the implicit timeout. After that, it will try for the next one. If again it is not matching, it will wait for another, right? You can see it's matching, that is the reason it's not waiting. It is like entering the value here. Okay, now let's change it to in input text 1. So it will not be matched, right? So what happened? It will wait for 20 seconds, then it will try for the next one, ID. In case ID will be matching, obviously it will enter the value. Okay, so let's change it to 1. Okay, so let's see then what is happening. Let's close it. Okay, let's run it. Let's see. First, class name will be not matching, so it will try to validate the second one, ID, right, with which is email. So obviously it will pass and it will enter the value Haradhan Pal 1 after waiting 20 seconds, because in case any of the attribute is getting failed, so it will wait for the implicit timeout, whatever you have given, right? So you can see first condition is not matching, so it will wait for 20 second. After that, it will wait for the, it will, I mean, check for the second condition. Then if it is matching, then it will enter the value. So it will wait for 20 seconds. After that, it will enter the value because second condition will be matching here. Here you can see Haradhan Pal 1 is already entered after waiting for 20 seconds. Okay, and skip is working fine. Okay, so let's change it to email 1 also. So the second condition will also not match. What happened? It will go for the third condition. Before going to the third condition, change it to 2. So it will wait for 20 seconds here and 20 seconds for the next element. And whenever third element located is going, it will wait for total 40 seconds. But in case third element also getting matched, so it will obviously enter the value. And then PAL 2, right? And your skip will not fail. Okay, let's run the code. Let's see what is happening. So it will open the Chrome browser. It will try to launch. It after launching, it will maximize it. It will enter the URL for Facebook. It will try to find the element for, with the class first. Here class will be failing. So it will wait for 20 seconds. Then it will go for the second condition. It will also fail. And again, it will wait for 20 seconds. After that, it will go for the third condition. And again, it will pass. So obviously, the enter value will be entered right in the email field, Haradhan Pal 2. So you can see 20 seconds already gone. Another 20 seconds will wait because second condition also failing. So after that, 40 seconds elapsed. It will go for the third condition. And in third condition is getting passed. So it will be entering the value. Yeah, you can see third condition is getting passed. That is the reason it is entering the value. And your test script will not be failed. Okay, so it is expected, right? So it will be expected. Now, if your third condition also getting failed, what will happen? Then it will throw the error that element is not visible. Okay, it will wait total 60 seconds, 20, 20, 20, because three element locator we have given. Okay, so let's run the code and let's see. So what is happening? It will fail the test case. It will not add the value, right? Enter the value. Because the three condition, whatever is the name, email ID, and class name is not matching. None of them is matching. So it every time it will wait for 20 seconds for each the element locator conditions and value, and after that, after 60 seconds elapsed, it will fail the test case. So it will go sequential. Whatever element locator you are giving first. So it will check for that, the next, and then next, and so on, like that. In case your first condition is getting passed, obviously it will all the really next condition, whatever you, is there, pass or fail, it does not matter. It will check for the first to last. In case if it is matching with the first one, it will not go for the second one. Okay. But in case the first second is not matching, then it will go for the third, fourth, like that. And whenever it is matching found, it will not wait. Immediately it will identify the element and it will perform the operation. But in case none of the condition, whatever you have given, like 4, 5, like that, okay, you can enter n number of condition here by comma separated. Okay, in case any of the condition is getting matched, your test case will not fail. It will just wait only for the implicit type, whatever you have given for every condition. Here total 20 seconds, that means 60 seconds it will wait, and after that it will throw the error. Because three different wave element I have given, so every time 20 seconds, that means 60 seconds it will be waiting. Okay, I think that you can see right now error message is coming, right? Cannot locate element by all class name, okay, whatever you have given, ID and email as well. Three different properties, element locator properties you have given, but still it is not able to identify it and it is getting failed, right? Okay, error message is coming by locator like that. Now let's correct the first condition, and second and third condition is not correct, right? Second and third ID element and name element is not correct because it is email, but I have provided email 111. Here I have corrected the first condition, it will be matching, right? So obviously my test case will be passed. Particular, right? value will be entered, right? Rather than pal 3, because it will go for the first to last. And in case any condition is getting met, it will not go for the last one. It will not validate even. Let's run the code and let's see what is happening. So it will launch the Facebook page. Once the page is fully loaded, it will try to identify it. Right, you can see the class is matching, that is the reason immediately it is entering the value in the email field, and it will not validate whether name or email is correct or not, name or ID is correct or not, because anything is matching, it will not wait for the others. It will ends, it will validate from first to last attribute whatever you are giving in sequence. Okay, so test case is getting passed here. Okay, so that's why, right, you can use the by all methods, okay, available in org.openqueue.selenium support.phpactory, right, packages. Okay, and you need to import it, otherwise you can't perform any operation. Okay, and after that you can give multiples element locator and element locator value. So in case any of the locator is matching, it will pass your test case, and in case it is not matching, so it will wait for the implicit wait time whatever you are giving. After that you will try to check for the next condition, and in case none of the condition is matching, then it will throw the error, right, and fail the test case. But in case any of the condition is matching, so it will pass the test case. So that is the one important major attribute of the by all method, so that you can avoid, right, whenever there is a probability that your multiple attribute can be changed, so you can use it with the multiple attribute as much as possible, so that your test case will not be failed and you can proceed to the next step, right, or next test case. Okay, that's all for today's session. Thank you.